Hello, welcome to the channel. With the recent performance updates of RPCS3, I'm sure you're curious to see how the game Red Dead Redemption performs on it. As promised, I bring you today an updated comparison of this game between RPCS3 and Xenia Canary. While no major updates have been announced for Xenia Canary, the emulator has undergone some changes. Before we dive into the comparison, I kindly ask you to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to receive future comparisons and stay up to date with the latest emulation news.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
First of all, there are rumors that Rockstar is preparing for a remake or remaster of the first Red Dead Redemption. However, while we wait for confirmation on that information, our only option is to emulate the game. Additionally, there is always the possibility that the game may be released similarly to the GTA The Trilogy, which was considered a poorly executed port. While we await the official announcement, we can enjoy Red Dead Redemption on RPCS3 and Xenia. Based on the latest updates of these two emulators, the question arises, where should we play today? Which emulator offers better performance on my PC? That's what we're going to discuss today. Before we dive into a side-by-side comparison, it's important to understand the limitations of each emulator so you have an idea of where to start. RPCS3 is currently the most demanding emulator in terms of CPU processing power, specifically single-threaded performance. On the other hand, Xenia takes a different approach, placing more emphasis on GPU performance and less on CPU processing. Therefore, the first tip is to assess which aspect you have invested more in hardware-wise. If you have a more powerful GPU, Xenia is the better choice. On the other hand, if you have a CPU with high performance in terms of processing cores, RPCS3 may be the ideal choice. With that being said, let's proceed with our comparisons, keeping in mind that currently, I have a much better GPU than my processor. Therefore, you will certainly see better results on Xenia. Our first test will involve a horse ride, starting from a busy urban area and heading towards an open area in the countryside. It's important to keep in mind that this is a demanding situation for the hardware, as the character can enter almost every building, which means both indoor and outdoor areas are being rendered, even if they are not visible on the screen. When comparing the results, it's important to consider that RevaTuner statistics probably can't provide accurate readings for my processor. I noticed that even though it shows 90% usage, when checking in Windows, at least 3 cores were at 100% utilization, with the remaining cores above 90%. Although the program is up to date, it simply doesn't display accurate information. Unfortunately, the only more precise program for conducting these tests is FPS Monitor, but it's not working properly with emulators that use the Vulkan API. With both emulators running at the same resolution, there is a significant performance difference in favor of Xenia. It consumes fewer resources overall and provides up to 3 times better performance than RPCS3. Additionally, when comparing the render trees in the background, it's noticeable that the RPCS3 version has more peculiar leaves, while the Xenia Canary version renders objects more accurately and true to the original console. Even in more open areas away from the city, RPCS3 still has lower frame rates. However, as mentioned earlier, not all PCs will have such an absurd difference in performance. But in extensive areas, Xenia still shows its superiority, with an average of 74 FPS, while RPCS3 only reaches 23 FPS at the moment. In the 1% loop, it's clear that Xenia offers smoother performance, with 43 FPS compared to 12 FPS on RPCS3. Finally, we arrive at Thieves' Landing, where performance drops again on both emulators, with an average of 72 FPS on Xenia versus 23 FPS on RPCS3. As can be observed in the background video, this city has large structures, putting even more strain on the hardware and emulators. At the end of this first test, which covers the entire journey, we have an average of 68 FPS on Xenia versus 21 FPS on RPCS3. The minimum FPS is 38 on Xenia versus 12 on RPCS3, and the maximum FPS is 89 on Xenia versus 36 on RPCS3. This represents a resounding victory for Xenia, with almost 250% additional performance. In the second test, we will take a carriage ride in one of the game's missions. In terms of performance, near the city, it's practically impossible to achieve good performance using my CPU, but as we move away a bit, RPCS3 manages to maintain a 30 FPS rate, making it playable. When comparing the minimum and maximum FPS values, while RPCS3 reached a maximum of 33 FPS, Xenia achieved 86 FPS. This difference in performance is huge, not to mention that Xenia consumes less RAM, making it possible to use it even on systems with only 8 GB of RAM. Now, let's get to some action. Here we face issues as it's very difficult to aim and have smooth movement with the 23 FPS on our PCS3. Throughout our test, the maximum FPS on Xenia reached 95, while on our PCS3, the maximum was only 30 FPS. Additionally, VRAM usage on our PCS3 exceeds the 4 GB mark. I will set aside our PCS3 for now since there isn't much I can do to improve its performance at the moment. Instead, let's test the resolution modes in Xenia to see how higher resolutions impact the hardware and how far I can push it with my current setup. Currently, there are two methods to increase the resolution in Xenia. The first one is by increasing the internal resolution, but I must admit that I have achieved modest results with this feature. At times, it seems like the function is not working properly because even when using an internal resolution of 1080p, the performance is sometimes better than the native resolution, which doesn't make much sense to me. Additionally, VRAM usage remains the same, which is strange. However, this could be related to some resolution enhancement patches. I have checked all my patches, and I couldn't find anything related to resolution. Therefore, the conclusion is that this function may not be working correctly. Another method of increasing the resolution in this emulator is through draw resolution scale, which allows you to multiply the horizontal or vertical resolution, even reaching 4K if desired. You can also increase only the vertical resolution and keep the horizontal resolution at the native resolution. You can customize it however you prefer in this mode. In this mode, I was able to improve the game's quality even with a draw resolution scale of 2. The game already performs very well, and I can maintain an average FPS above 60, at the cost of increased GPU load. Using a draw resolution scale of 3, the actual game resolution reaches 4K, but the GPU load is doubled, and the game remains playable, surpassing 30 FPS. An almost perfect optimization option for 1080p, with very little aliasing, is to enable the option in Red Dead Redemption's patches that renders the game internally at 540p with 4x MSAA. Then, change the draw resolution scale for both X and Y to 2. With this configuration, the game stays above 60 FPS outside of cities and presents an incredible visual quality. The best part is that you can enable this enhancement even on a GPU with 4 GB of VRAM. Amazing, isn't it? Our final test will be using the Vulkan API in Xenia. We all know that Vulkan offers better performance in any emulator where it is available. However, in the case of Xenia, although the Vulkan API has been available for over a year, there are still many bugs, making its use unfeasible. While I would have liked to delve deeper into this game, it is very difficult to make progress in RPCS3 due to the low frame rate. Therefore, I need to present my conclusions here. As mentioned at the beginning of the video, performance may vary depending on whether you have a good processor or a good GPU. If you have an Intel Core i5 10th or 11th generation processor, or an equivalent from AMD, along with a GTX 1660, which is currently the most widely used GPU, I can confidently say that the best option is Xenia Canary. Despite this emulator still having many issues, it is fully capable of running Red Dead Redemption. If you're not familiar with Xenia, or it has been a while since you've given this emulator a chance, know that its performance has improved significantly. Additionally, you can play in 4K resolution with minimal performance issues, as seen in the gameplay footage. On the other hand, when it comes to RPCS3, it is important to note that Red Dead Redemption is still not in a playable state in the emulator. This means that the development team has not yet fully optimized it to achieve decent performance. When RPCS3 compiles its compatibility list, they take it very seriously and consider only the games that can run even on average PCs as playable. Therefore, my recommendation for playing this game on RPCS3 is to have a high-performance processor, such as Intel's 12th and 13th generation core processors, or AMD equivalents. In this case, it's not about the number of cores in the processor, but rather the performance it offers in a single core. For example, having a Xeon processor with 20 threads won't provide better performance than an Intel Core i5 with 16 threads. However, I believe that most people don't invest a large amount of money just to emulate old console games. Based on the hardware that most of the channel's followers send me on Discord, I can say that in these circumstances, most people will have better performance with Xenia. Even with my old GPU, a GTX 970, I was able to achieve frame rates above 40 FPS in more open areas using Xenia Canary, while RPCS3, before receiving better optimizations for this game, will always have significantly lower performance. The golden rule here is to evaluate your hardware and identify its strengths to decide which emulator to use, or simply try both and determine which works best for your hardware. I hope the video has been helpful for you. See you in the next one.